short, because it's only 3-4 minutes, and then you will find the mezzo is full in the back and empty from the front. So if you have any spot in front of you, please fill it. I can see the third row spaces. So please, if you have any spot in front of you, please move up to second row. This is easier for you. Nobody has to step over your neck, and easier for those who come later, inshallah. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا إنه من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين ولا إله إلا الله إلهنا وإله الأولين والآخرين وقيوم السماوات والأرضين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه أرسله الله تبارك وتعالى رحمة للعالمين وإماما للمتقين وحجة علينا نحن الخلائق أجمعين فأخرجنا به من ظلمات الكفر إلى نور الإيمان بالله رب العالمين اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء فاتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما اغتنام الفرص وعلى رأسها فرصة الأيام أو مواسم الخير سنة سنها لنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم دعوني أبدأ سريعا بهذه القصة هذا رجل من الأثرياء أجريت معه مقابلة فقال له من يسأله هل لك أن تبين لنا كيف أصبحت من أغنى الأغنياء أو كيف أصبحت مليونيرا وريبرتز يعني أين كان المسمى فأخرج من جيبه مباشرة شيكا على بياض وأعطاه له وقال له هذا لك أكتب ما تراه من المبلغ وهو لك يعني أكتب اللي أنت عاوزه والفلوس لك مباشرة فالرجل مجري المقابلة من الخجل ومن الصدمة قال له يعني أنا لم أعني ذلك ولا أريد مالا ولا أريد ذلك أبدا فأخذ هذا الثري الشيك مرة أخرى ووضعه في جيبه ثم قال له هكذا أصبحت أنا غنيا كيف؟ قال لأني لم أضيع فرصة أبدا أنتهز كل الفرص من خلالها ازددت ثراء على ثراء أما أنتم تضيعون الفرص كانت أمامك فرصة سانحة لأن تصبح غنيا مثلي ولكنك يعني ضيعتها So today I'm trying to again be as I try always to be up to date few days are coming One of the best days of the year. I'm not going to talk about the virtue of the days, maybe during the halaqas, during during the week will be touching that. But today my topic is about taking advantage of the chances and the opportunities that you have, and not to waste anything that comes to you and to refuse it. This is what I just said in Arabic. One of the rich people, somebody is interviewing him and asking him a very simple question. How did you become one of the richest people on earth? And this is, by the way, it's a real story. He told him to answer. He got his checkbook and he gave him one check. And he told him, you know what? Please write the amount that you wish in this check and it's for you. So the interviewer got shocked and so shy, and he told him, no, I'm not asking you to give me money. I don't want it. I don't want your money. So he took his check back, put it in his pocket, and he told them, that's how I became very rich, because I never wasted any opportunity to make myself rich. You guys are wasting a lot. I give you the money and you refuse it. I never refuse anything. I never refuse a gift that anybody give it to you. And this is, by the way, you will find a very close match to this in the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. When you talk about taking advantage of a chance, listen to this hadith. Hadith rawahu Sayyidina Abu Musa al-Ash'ari radiyallahu anhu wa awradahu Ibn Hibban wa sahahahu al-Imam al-Albani. Yaqul, qala Rasulullah sallallahu aw anna an-nabiy sallallahu alayhi wasallam زار أعرابيا فأكرمه. Again, this hadith is very close to the meaning of this story. And I need to start with both of them to give you a better idea of what I'm talking about today. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abu Musa al-Ash'ari said, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one day, he visited a Bedouin man. فأكرمه. And he was so generous with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فقال له النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ائتنا. يعني زرنا نريد أن نكرمك. فجاء الرجل وزار النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال له النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم اسأل تعطى سل. فقال الرجل يا رسول الله ما هي إلا ناقة نركبها وعنز يحلبها قوم. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم told him, after he was so generous with him, please visit us. This is authentic hadith. Visit us. So he visited the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then he told him, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told him, you know what? You're here at my place. You ask and you will be answered. Whatever you want, I'll give you. The guy was shy. You know what? You know what? All what I need? Just a she camel for me to use it as a ride, and few female goats for my family to milk. I don't need more than this. فَقَالَ لَهُ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ وَلَنَا جَمِيعًا أعجزتم أن تكونوا مثل عجوز بني إسرائيل. The Prophet ﷺ told him, يا رجل, يعني, aren't you able to be like the old lady of بني إسرائيل? And the Sahaba around the Prophet ﷺ, Sahaba حول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال يا رسول الله ومن عجوز بني إسرائيل. فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لما سار موسى عليه السلام ببني إسرائيل من مصر ضلوا الطريق تاهوا. فقال ما هذا؟ فقال علماء بني إسرائيل لسيدنا موسى عليه السلام إن يوسف حينما حضره الموت أوثق أو عهد إلينا ألا نخرج من مصر حتى نأخذ عظامه معنا حتى نأخذ جسده معنا. فقال ومن يعرف قبره؟ سيدنا موسى يسأل ومن يعرف قبره؟ يوسف عليه السلام قالوا عجوز بني إسرائيل. So now the man asked for this. The Prophet ﷺ told him, يا أخي, when you ask for something great. When you have a chance, take advantage of it. You, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you something, get it. Accept it. Don't refuse it. Be like the old lady of Bani Israel. Then the Sahaba asked the Prophet ﷺ, who's this lady? What's the story of this lady? The Prophet ﷺ said, when Musa alayhi salam was leaving Misr, Egypt, like lots of people today are leaving Egypt. So when Musa was leaving Egypt, and Bani Israel, children of Israel, were with him, They got lost in the desert. Then Musa alayhi salam told them, what's wrong with you guys? You don't know how to get out of here? We got stuck. Then some of their scholars, they remembered something. They told them, Ya Musa, Yusuf alayhi salam, when he was on his deathbed, he took a covenant on us, or we took a covenant with him, that we will not leave Egypt without taking his remains with us. Okay, that's a bequest, a will of a prophet, so you have to do it. Then Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam asked, who knows the grave of Yusuf alayhi salam? They said the only person who knows where is the grave of Yusuf alayhi salam is an old lady from Bani Israel. فَأَرْسَلَ إِلَيْهَا دُلِّينَا عَلَى قَبْرِ يُوسُفْ فَقَالَتْ لَا والله أتذكر في نفس الإطار قول سيدنا عمرو بن العاص رضي الله عنه لرسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم حينما أسلم، قال له يا عم ابسط يدك وبايعني، فقال له لا حتى أشترط، وما شرطك يا عم؟ قال حتى يغفر لي، والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بين له أن الإسلام يجوب ما قبله. فقالت هذه المرأة لسيدنا موسى عليه السلام، لا حتى تعطيني حكمي. So he said to her, he brought her, where is the grave of Yusuf عليه السلام? She said that I know where is it, but I'm not gonna tell you until you give me what I want. وما هو حكمه? What do you want? قالت أن أكون معك في الجنة. I want to be with you in Jannah. She's asking Musa alayhi salam to take her with him to Jannah, but it's out of his capacity. He cannot do it. فلم يرد عليها موسى عليه السلام. The point here is, take advantage of everything you have. The lady got a chance, she's not gonna waste it. She tells him, you know what, she can ask for money. She can ask like this guy for a she camel, for a few goats and sheep. She never asked for anything like that. She asked for something worth it. Until you give me what I want. فقال لها, I can't, it's not in my hand. فأوحى الله إليه يا موسى أن أعطيها ما طلبت. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala right away revealed to Musa, give her what she asked for. Give her that. Give her the promise that she will be with you in Jannah. She got it. فقالت لهم اتبعوني فأخذتهم إلى بحيرة. فقالت لهم انضبوا الماء من البحيرة ثم احتفروا فاحتفروا فأخرجوا جسد يوسف عليه السلام فما أن أقلوها إلا وجدوا الطريق أمامهم قضاء النهار. So she told them exactly where is it. It's in this lake. Take the water out. They got the remains of Yusuf alayhi salam. Then right away they found the road clear in front of them. This is one of the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. When you have a chance, you take advantage of it. You and I, we have the time every day. والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول في الحديث الصحيح حديث سيدنا أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه في البخاري النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول نعمتان حديث عبد الله بن عباس في البخاري يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم نعمتان مغبون فيهما كثير من الناس الصحة والفراغ. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the authentic hadith, I'm trying to change my strategy today by translating quickly, because I got a request last week, one of the brothers, I'm gonna say it out of like, nobody knows him for sure, but the brother came to me and said that I don't understand your Arabic. Brother, do you speak Arabic? He said, no. Then why you don't understand my Arabic? Do you understand my English? He said, yes, but I don't understand your Arabic. So I hope that I can't speak every language in the masjid. Well, I'll try. But I did try, but it's hard. I'll try my best today to translate as quick as I can. The Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that there are two blessings that everybody wastes. Actually, we are wasting these two ni'mah, two blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us. Number one is your health, your body, your energy, and number two always is the free time that we have. And I'm coming to the time. And I'm trying to introduce you to these days that we are commencing very soon, inshallah ta'ala. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في أحاديث عدة في مواقف عدة بيّن لنا صلى الله عليه وسلم بالعمل وليس بالكلام وليس بالقول فقط بيّن لنا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أهمية استغلال الوقت الاستغلال الأمثل حتى وإن كنت يعني تحسبه أو تحسبه وقت فراغ عندك النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لم يضيع وقتا أبدا دون استثمار هذا حديث المغيرة بن شعبة رضي الله عنه يقول كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم حديث البخاري يقول كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يا شباب أنا today I'm trying my best to motivate myself and to motivate everybody to take advantage of the few days that we're starting very soon on Sunday. So please pay attention and take the ways and the behavior of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam always as your guide. That's how he used to use his time sallallahu alaihi wasallam. هذا حديث المغيرة بن شعبة رضي الله عنه يقول كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقوم يصلي من الليل حتى تتورم قدماه صلى الله عليه وسلم فلما قيل له يا رسول الله لما تفعل ذلك وقد غفر الله لك ما تقدم من ذنبك وما تأخر قال صلى الله عليه وسلم أفلا أكون عبدا شكورا ليس فقط أن تقوم بأداء الفرائض وإنما تقدم لنفسك عملا تقف به أمام الله تبارك وتعالى وأن تستثمر هذه الأوقات الفضيلة والفاضلة في الإضافة إلى الأعمال. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم again, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم showed us how to use and how to take advantage of the time through his behavior, through his actions صلى الله عليه وسلم. Not only take advantage of the time as the hadith that we mentioned earlier. No, he said it practically, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He used to do that. He used to apply what he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sayyidina al-Mughira ibn al-Shu'ba, radiallahu anhu, reported that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to stand in prayer during the night time until his feet got swollen. Then he was asked, Ya Rasulullah, everybody knows. Allah said that clearly in the Quran, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forgiven your previous and future sins. Why you have to do that for yourself? Believe me. Yani, be honest with yourself. If you got, there are some people, by the way, they are misled by the fact that a human being can forgive them. They're totally misled. They've changed their aqeedah. They don't want to get the truth because of that. Somebody tells you, you know what? Stay with me, you will be rescued. You will be saved. We'll give you the salvation, whatever term are they're using for that. And the people follow them for that because they know and he is drinking and he is stealing and he is doing all the bad stuff. Getting out based on the fact that he is getting some salvation at a certain point. So imagine that the Prophet was told clearly in the Quran that your previous and future sins are forgiven. However, he used to stand in prayer, take advantage of the time, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, until his feet got swollen. Then when he was asked, he said clearly, أَفَلَا أَكُونُ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا Shall I not be a grateful, a thankful servant to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? That's the hadith. That's the guidance of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in using the time. And by the way, when we talk about the night time, we're talking about sunnah, we're talking about nawafil, we're talking about extra ibadah that he used to do sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to be a grateful servant to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not only this, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, يعني هو علم الصحابة وصحابة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كانوا أحرص على الوقت من أي إنسان آخر كانوا حريصين كل الحرص أن يقدموا لأنفسهم في وقتهم قدر استطاعتهم لذلك هذا سيدنا أبو بكر الصديق رضي الله عنه في حديث سيدنا أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه يقول في البخاري، يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بين أصحابه، صدقني لو سألت السؤال ده لأي حد هتلاقي عنده صعوبة رهيبة إنه يجيب هذا السؤال، صعوبة شديدة جدا أن تجتمع هذه الأمور في شخص. وعلى النقيض حينما تحدثت في هذا الحديث بالتحديد، لو جعلت هذا الحديث قائدا لك في هذه الأيام ستكون من أهل الجنة كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. تحدثت عنه سابقا في شمال المدينة وفوجئت برد فعل بعض الشباب بأنهم كانوا حريصين كل الحرص أن يطبقوا هذه الأربع كل يوم، لكن من الصعب أن تجد فينا من يطبق هذه الأمور بشكل منتظم، من يتخذ أو يستغل الوقت وينتهز فرصة الوقت يعني قدر الاستطاعة. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يجلس مع أصحابه ذات يوم فيقول: من أصبح منكم اليوم صائما؟ يقول صائما يعني الموضوع مش في رمضان، خارج رمضان. فيقول سيدنا أبو بكر الصديق: أنا يا رسول الله أنا صائم. فمن تبع منكم اليوم جنازة؟ فيقول أبو بكر: أنا يا رسول الله. فمن أطعم منكم اليوم مسكينا؟ فيقول أبو بكر: أنا يا رسول الله. فمن زار منكم اليوم مريضا أو من عاد منكم اليوم مريضا؟ فيقول أبو بكر: أنا يا رسول الله. فيقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لأبي بكر ولكل إنسان يسعى جاهدا أن يستغل وقته استغلالا صحيحا، يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم: ما اجتمعنا في امرئ هذه الأربع إلا دخل الجنة. Not only the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. When you look at the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he is a prophet. He's different than us. Yeah, he is. That's why when Sayyidina Al-Qama رضي الله عنه came to Sayyidina Aisha رضي الله عنها and asked her clearly, هل كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يخص بعض الأيام بشيء أو بشيء؟ يعني did the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to specialize certain days with certain عبادة؟ فقالت: لا يا القمة، بل كان عمله ديمة. He used to be always like that. But من منكم يطيق ما كان يطيق رسول الله أو يطيق ما كان يطيق رسول الله؟ No one would be able to do that with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. I agree with you. If you take this hadith and tell me, يا شيخ, يعني the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was special, but the Sahaba, the companions of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, when you see some people today are accusing them with things that it's absolutely wrong, trying to tell you that they were human beings, they are human beings. But don't look at this aspect and try to accuse them with false accusation. Look at the other aspect. They are human like you, but they used to be more devoted to this religion way more than you. Why don't you look at this aspect of their life? So Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam one day with his Sahaba, and he's asking very simple question. And I said in Arabic earlier, it's hard to find one Muslim amongst us today in this masjid who fulfill the four things that we're talking about today. How many janazas happens here in Edmonton and you never even thought to go follow the janaza unless it's a friend or a family friend? You don't go just for going to follow the janaza of a Muslim. You don't go visit the hospital here. Lots of Muslims are there. You never thought of going to say, Assalamu alaikum, I'm here to visit you. You never know when we talk to them how happy they are when somebody goes that they don't know just to say, Assalamu alaikum, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you the shifa. They are so happy. You never thought of going to a Muslim and feed him or provide him with something for the sake of Allah. That's why we're taking, we're saying there is a time that you have to use. What are you doing? I know. You take your kids to the soccer, I take them. You take your kids to the swimming, I know. Because we are in the same boat, everybody's doing the same. But do something for yourself. Add something for yourself. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells you, there are days, they're bigger than the rest of the days, you have to stop, think about yourself. You have to think about adding to yourself during these days, whatever you can. That's why Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is asking a very simple question. Who's fasting today for the sake of Allah? Not because of Ramadan, not because he's making up for the days that she missed or he missed. No, just for the sake of Allah. Listening to the advice of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, وَصُومُ يَوْمًا شَدِيدٌ حَرٌّ. fast on a hot day. Just remember the longest hot day ever. لطول يوم النشور. Who is fasting today? Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. Yes, I'm fasting, Ya Rasulullah. Who followed a janaza today? Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. I did follow a janaza today. Who give or provide food to a poor person or give sadaqah today? Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. I did. It's one day. The same day. Look how they used to. Those people, they were busy fighting. They were from battle to battle to battle to battle. In 23 years of the da'wah, the da'wah life of the Prophet ﷺ, if you go read the history and the seerah of your Prophet, you will know that you cannot even imagine how they used to use their time. Traveling, going from here to there. And that's the, how many ahadith stories came from the life of the Prophet ﷺ. Because they were not like you and I, wasting lots of their time on Xbox. I'm telling you, I'm watching TV, I'm watching soccer games, the World Cup, everybody was talking about it because we were like excited and wasting lots of time. And here is a chance for you and for me, a great opportunity for you and me to take advantage of, which is the 10 days. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who did give sadaqah today, Abu Bakr? And last thing, who visited a sick person today, Abu Bakr? He did. Look what he said to him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to Abu Bakr and to you. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, these four things, if they get together in one person, he is from the people of Jannah. مَجْتَمَعْنَا فِي بْرِئٍ إِلَّا دَخَلَ الْجَنَّةِ. If you do these four things, I'm giving you a plan. I'm giving you something to do, and it's easy. You need to get to the hospital, go and check. Lots of them. You need to give sadaqah, absolutely. Janaza, if you put yourself on the main list, you will get it easily. Lots of janaza happening every day or every week you will have janaza. Do it. Do it and take advantage of the time. And let me conclude the first khutbah with the statement that Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu made clear. And you and I have to think about it. يقول radiallahu anhu Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Mas'ud ما ندمت على شيء أبداً ما ندم على شيء أبداً في حياته إلا يوم زاد نقص فيه عمري ولم يزد فيه عملي. I never, he said, رضي الله عنه سيدنا عبد الله بن مسعود, I never regretted anything. Oh, you regret lots. Some of us regretted that he got married. Not some of us, most of us. So we regret. Everybody regretted this. And I hope that, I wish I didn't do it. I wish I didn't do it. He said, I never regretted anything except one thing. The day that passes, in which my umr, my age got shorter. Alas, I'm getting older, so my age is shorter, and my amal doesn't get increased. That's the only thing that you and I should regret in our life. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم أدعو الله تبارك وتعالى وأنتم الحمد لله وكفى وصلاة وسلاما على عباده الذين اصطفى أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له أشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وبعد خذ ما تحدثت عنه في الخطبة الأولى وضعه بجانب هذين الحديثين أولاً النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول أفضل أيام الله أيام العشر. So take what I, if you still remember what we talked about in the first khutbah, which is in general, taking advantage of the time, taking advantage of the chances that we have in this life. And then put it next to these two ahadith. Number one, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the best days ever throughout the whole year are the first 10 days of the Hijjah. والحديث الثاني قول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في حديث سيدنا عبد الله بن عباس رضي الله عنه قال صلى الله عليه وسلم: ما من أيام العمل الصالح فيها أحب إلى الله منها في هذه العشر. قال: ولا الجهاد يا رسول الله؟ قال: ولا الجهاد إلا رجل خرج بنفسه وماله فلم يرجع بشيء. The second hadith is the saying of the Prophet ﷺ. Hadith came with the authority of Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas, reported by Imam Ahmad, Imam Bukhari, there are no days during the whole year the good deeds or the righteous deeds are more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in them than the first 10 days of the Hijjah. Then the Sahaba then asked, Ya Rasulullah, even jihad, if you do jihad outside the 10 days, it's not going to be better than praying during the first 10 days? It's not going to be better than giving sadaqah during the first 10 days? It's not going to be better than fasting during the first 10 days or 9 days of the Hijjah? He said, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, no, not even jihad, except in one case. Somebody who goes out for jihad himself and all of his money, and he comes back with nothing. He sacrificed himself, his life, and his property, his wealth, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You got the chance and the time to be like this man who sacrificed all of his money, all of his life, and all of his wealth and his money for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 9 days, man. 9 days, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he talked about it, he did not specify a certain act of worship. Some people can fast, others they cannot. Some people they have money, they can give sadaqah, others they cannot. Some people they can pray more during the night, others they cannot. Some people can be good to the people, they can da'wah, others they cannot. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave it to us in a non-specific way. Do whatever you want. Keep in your mind, in your heart, that what you're doing during the first 10 days of the Hijjah is something is always unique. You're doing with the intention that you're getting a great reward, and that the same thing, yani the same prayer that you're praying during the first 10 days, you pray today, you're going to be praying next week, with the intention it will be more in ajr. The sunnah will be more in ajr. Reading Quran will be more in ajr. Making dhikr will be more in ajr. Giving sadaqat will be more in ajr. Getting, yani doing a good, just like being nice to the people will be more in ajr. And take advantage of this. وأنا يعني حقيقة يعني I always try to finish early. But يعني سبحان الله, those Egyptian people, they love to talk, man. Anyway, the main thing behind this is to take advantage of the ni'mah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaqul fi hadith al-sahih, إِنَّ لِلَّهِ فِي أَيَّامِ دَهْرِكُمْ لِنَفَحَاتٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has always special times for you, gifts, special gifts for you. أَلَا فَتَعَرَّضُوا لَهَا. Just go and accept it. That's the main thing. That should be your plan. So inshallah ta'ala, from this Sunday, inshallah ta'ala, it will be mostly Sunday, inshallah ta'ala, will be the start of the first 10 days of the Hijjah. Whatever you can do, add to yourself with this intention and take advantage of the opportunity, take advantage of the time, and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from you and from us and make us all inshallah ta'ala from the people of Jannah, and try to make this hadith the hadith of Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu to be your drive in the first 10 days of Hijjah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. اللهم كما رزقتنا ووهبتنا هذه الأيام المباركة, اللهم بارك لنا فيها, وفقنا للعمل الصالح في هذه الأيام المباركة, أيام العشر من ذي الحجة, وتقبل منا أعمالنا واجعلها يا رب خالصة لوجهك الكريم. وصلى اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. وأقم الصلاة إن الصلاة كانت على المؤمنين كتابا موقوتا.
الله.